Well, the human vestibular system is very interesting because it's part of what lets us understand our surroundings. And in order for us to move and to interact and to do things in our environment, we have to know the speed that we're moving, the direction that we're moving, and then we have to be able to identify the things that we're moving towards and that we're reacting with on a daily basis. When the vestibular system becomes imbalanced, or the visual system is not symmetric to the information that comes from the inner ears or the information from your joints, there becomes a mismatch. And so the internal representation of the reality around us is no longer appropriate or matched. So it becomes something that we don't perceive correctly, and it can be confusing, or we can be dizzy, or we can be disoriented, or we may not walk correctly, or we can't identify targets at the right depth. And it can change all kinds of things, the way your eyes move, the way you feel, the way you think. It can increase some of your autonomic nervous system, which are things that control your pulse and your heart and your ability even to control your own bowel and bladder function. And then it can go all the way up to cognition. It can make people suffer, or it can give people anxiety, or even perpetuate depression. So the vestibular system is not only important to be able to diagnose the right way, but then to be able to treat it as a part of a lot of other neurological situations is imperative, and we utilize that in our practice.